In this segment, we'll talk about how to solve second-order linear elliptic partial differential equations by using the Lieberman method. We're showing it in two parts. The first part will be concerned with the theory, and the second part will be concerned with the example. If you want more details about this particular method, all you have to do is to go to the Numerical Methods webpage, click on keyword, and click on elliptic partial differential equations. So again, what we are doing is that we are using the same physical example of an elliptic partial differential equation, where we are saying that, hey, we want to be able to find out what the temperature in this plate is. It's a rectangular plate, but it can be a plate which doesn't have to be necessarily rectangular. So just to keep the algebra simple, we are assuming a rectangular plate. The temperatures at the four edges is given to us, and we want to find out what the steady state temperature will be inside this particular plate. And the steady state temperature in this plate is governed by this Laplacian equation. It's a second order linear elliptic partial differential equation, and we need to figure out how can we find out the temperatures at different points in this particular plate as we are trying to solve this particular problem numerically. So we have talked about that we have discretized the equation here, the Laplacian equation, by writing down this as a discretized equation of the Laplacian by simply saying that, hey, we have this node here, and we can write down the temperatures of that node in terms of the temperatures of the surrounding nodes, which are this node, this one, and this one. And of course, we are also assuming that delta x is same as delta y. That's how we get an equation which looks simplified as this. If delta x is not equal to delta y, then we can still write down the equation in discretized form, but then delta x and delta y will also be part of the equation. So if you recall, again, the discretized equation is given as this. The Gauss-Seidel method asks you to rewrite the equation for the node, for the temperature node I comma j, in terms of the temperatures at the other four nodes, which I just showed to you. And for the Gauss-Seidel method, this particular equation is solved iteratively for each and every node at which we don't know what the temperature, steady state temperature is, and we keep on iterating it till we find out that the pre-specified tolerance is met. So what is the difference in the Lieberman method? The difference in the Lieberman method is that we still use the Gauss-Seidel method, but what we are doing is that we are going to use, we're going to give weightage to the new temperature which we just have found out, and the temperature which we have previous in the, from the previous iteration. So we'll take a value of lambda and multiply it to the temperature which we just found out, and we will add to it 1 minus lambda times the temperature which we found out earlier in the previous iteration. So the value of lambda which is generally chosen is between 1 and 2, and that's why it's called over-relaxation, because you're going to give a lot more weight to the temperature which you have found now. You want to multiply the temperature which you have found now by a number which is between 1 and 2, and the previous temperature is going to get a weightage of 1 minus lambda, which will be a negative number there. And the reason why we are doing that is for one simple reason. We want to accelerate the convergence of finding these temperatures. And the reason why we're able to take such a route is because the coefficient matrix for this particular problem turns out to be diagonally dominant. And since it's diagonally dominant, we know that Gauss-Seidel method is guaranteed to convergence, and we accelerate this convergence process by choosing a lambda to be between 1 and 2. If you choose a lambda to be less than 1, that's also considered in some cases where you may find out that the process might be a little bit divergent, and in order to make that particular process convergent, you under-relax by choosing a lambda which is a number which is less than 1. So that's what the Lieberman method is all about, that it is the same as the Gauss-Seidel method, except for the fact that we revise our temperature estimate by giving a weightage to the current temperature the temperature from the current iteration and the temperature from the previous iteration. And that's the end of this segment, and we'll take an example in the next part of this segment.